Good morning. In this week's Parsha, Yitro, we read about the giving of the Torah, and there is a fascinating Gemara in Gemara Shabbos, page 88b, Pei Chet Amud Bet, that tells a story, a midrashic analogy, a story about what happened when Moshe came to heaven to get the Torah. See, he didn't just go up to Mount Sinai. The way our sages look at it is he went up to Mount Sinai and he went from there into heaven. And he spent 40 days in heaven receiving the Torah, after which he came down. And this is what the Gemara says about this trip to heaven. It says, Amar Rabbi Yehoshua ben Levi, Rabbi Yehoshua the son of Levi said, B'shah she'ala Moshe lemarom, at the time that Moshe came up to heaven, Amru malachei hasharet lifnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the ministering angel said in front of Hashem, Ribono shel olam, master of the world, Ma li'yolod isha beinenu? What is this one born of woman doing among us? What is a human being doing over here in heaven amongst the holy angels? Amar lehem, Hashem said to them, Lakabel Torah ba, he came to receive the Torah. Amru lefanav, they said to him, Chamuda genuza, shenigna zalacha, teisha meot v'shivim v'arba dorot kodem shenivra holam, the treasured possession that has been hidden away with you for 974 generations before the creation of the world. We'll come back to the number of 974 in a second. This treasure thing which has been kept there for 974 generations before the world was even created. You want to give that to flesh and blood? The holiest, most precious thing, you want to give that to a human being? And then the Gemara quotes a verse from the book of Tehillim. My nosh ketiz karena. What is a person that you should be mindful of him? Uven adam ki tifkerena, and son of man, that you should take note of him. Hashem Adonainu ma adir shimcha b'chol ha'aretz, asher tana hodcha al ha'shamayim. Hashem, how awesome is your name on over all the earth, that you give your glory over the heavens. The angels are basically saying, Hashem, don't mess around with these guys, give them the holy Torah. They're nobodies. Amar lo HaKadosh Baruch Hu leMoshe. Hashem says to Moshe, Hechazir lahem tshuva. Give them an answer. Amar lefanav, Moshe replies, Ribono shel olam, Mijiyare ani shema yisarfuni behevel shebafiyem. I am afraid that they will burn me with the breath of their mouths. Amar lo, Hashem says to him, Achoz b'kisei kvodi. Hold on to my throne of glory. V'chazor lahem, and give them an answer, teshuva an answer. Sheneemar, as the verse says, Ma'achaz paneki si parshaz alav ananu. He grabbed onto the face of the chair and he was able to answer. Another verse from the Tanakh. Va'amar Rabbi Nachum melamed shepiresh shtei maziv shkinato, shepiresh akai miziv shkinato, ve'ananu alav. That this teaches us that Hashem spread the light, the glory of his presence over Moshe, and made a cloud around him. Okay, so Moshe was protected by Hashem, and now he is able to answer the angels, to justify to them why he will receive the Torah. Amar lefanav, he says to Hashem, Ribono shel olam, master of the world, Torah she'ata noten li, ma ketuv ba, the Torah that you are going to give me, what is written in it? So Hashem answers, Anochi Hashem Elokecha asher etzeiticha me'eretz Mitzrayim. The first of the 10 statements, I am Hashem, your God, who has taken you out of Egypt. Amar lehen, the Moshe says to the angels, L'mitzrayim yiradatem? Did you go down to Egypt? L'faro hishtabadatem? Were you enslaved to Pharaoh? Torah lamata elachem? Why should you have the Torah? Shuv makativba. He turns back to Hashem and he says, Hashem, what else is written in it? Lo yelacha Elohim acherim. You may have no other gods, Hashem tells Moshe. So Moshe turns to the angels, Bain Amim Atem Shurim. She'ovdim Avorat Kochavim, he says to them, are you living amongst the angels who worship idols? Do you have those kinds of temptations that you would need a specific mitzvah to help you not to do that? Avorat Gilulim idols? Shuv Maketifa. What else, Moshe asks, Hashem is written in it? Zachor, Hashem answers, Zachor Juma Shabbat Lakadshu. Remember Shabbos to make it holy. Moshe says to them, "Klum atem osim melacha, shatim tzrichim shavut. Are you doing work that links to the concept of rest, of not work. You never do, you never have this work anyway. Shuv ma ketiva, what else is written in it? Lo tisa masa lo tisa. Do not take Hashem's name in vain. Do not take a false oath. So when is a person going to take a false oath? When they want to swear falsely about money. So Moshe says to them, Maso matan yesh b'neichem. Do you do business that you would be in danger of doing a false oath? Shuv ma ketiva, what else is written in the Torah? Kabeid et avicha ve'et imecha, honor your father and your mother. Avaim yesh lachem, do you have a father and a mother? Shuv ma ketiva, what else is written? Lo tirtzach, lo tinaf, lo tignov. Do not murder, do not commit adultery, do not steal. Kine yesh b'neichem. Yetzahara yesh b'neichem. Is there jealousy amongst you? Is there an evil inclination amongst you? Miyad hodu lo laKadosh Baruch Hu. Immediately they praised him to Hashem. Shenemar Hashem Elokeinu ma'adir shimcha. Hashem, how great is your name on the earth. And in fact, the Gemara concludes by saying that the angels each gave Moshe a gift. Maybe we'll discuss another time that what that means. The angels gave him a gift. But they each gave Moshe a gift, and he departed in peace and was able to take the Torah down to the Jewish people. What is this Gemara trying to tell us? So the first point, as I mentioned to you, I'd like to explain, is the 974 generations. Where does that number come from? Book of Tehillim, Book of Psalms says, Davar tziva le'elef dor. The Torah was given, the word of Hashem was given, le'elef dor, to the 1,000th generation. Torah was given after 1,000 generations of mankind. The sages look at this and they say, from Adam to Abraham was 10 generations. From Abraham to Noah was another, I beg your pardon, from Adam to Noah was 10 generations. From Noah to Abraham was another 10 generations, that's 20. And from Abraham to Moshe was 6 generations. So, was Abraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Levi, Kehat Amram and Moshe, or you could have said Levi Yocheved and Moshe. So Moshe was 26 generations after Adam. So when the Torah was given, it was given to the 26th generation. What do you mean 970? Well, what happened to the other 974? Where was the Torah commanded to the 1,000th generation? So sages explain that there were 974 generations before the creation of the world, before Adam. Okay, what that means is a discussion. The Maharal of Prague says what it means is that Hashem really should have given the Torah only after 1,000 generations. There really should have been many, many, many more times, not just the 26 from Adam to Moshe, but 1,000 generations to show how much greater the Torah is than the entire world, that the Torah is really above the entire world. The only problem is the world cannot exist without Torah. The world can't last without Torah. The world could only last for 26 generations before it became imperative that the Torah would be given. Why 26 generations? What's the significance of that number? So for that, the Maharal of Prague says that is the gematria, that is the numerical value of the name of Hashem, of the Yud and the He and the Vav and the He. The letters in Hebrew each have a numerical value. Yud is 10, He is 5, Vav is 6. Do the maths. Makes 26. That's the name of Hashem's compassion. The world could exist for 26 generations on Hashem's compassion. More than that, it couldn't. It needed the Torah. But in theory, there's 974 theoretical generations before the giving of the Torah. Now, that's point number one. But we want to take it further. What is going on with this conversation between Moshe and the angels? So, the Maggid of Dubna has a wonderful story to explain this. I hope you don't mind. I'm going to speed up a little bit because I see that I'm running a little short of time. So, the Maggid of Dubna has a wonderful story that he says, there was once a rabbi who served his community with distinction, and he was outstanding and everybody loved him, and he was able to just grow a community in Torah and Chesed and all good things. So after he had served for many, many years, he became old, and it was time for him to start winding down. The community needed a new, younger rabbi. And there was a small community that was willing to, that was very excited to take this rabbi on as he wound down his term of service to the Jewish people. So it was agreed with his community, he would step down with the new community who would come. Everyone was happy. And so off the rabbi is going, he packs his bags, he's ready to make the move. the day of the move comes, and as he's going down to the car that his new community has sent to chauffeur him, to escort him to them, all the committee of his old shul come down and block his way. And they say, "We're not letting you go." And the new community says, "But we're taking him." "No, no, you're not taking him. He's staying." They get into a whole argument and a fight. "He's staying, he's going, he's staying, he's going." Eventually, they take him with, and he goes. And when the rabbi gets to his new community, he picks up the phone. He calls back his old chairman. He says, "What's going on? We all agreed. Everything was decided upon. It was all above board." So the chairman says, "Yes, yes, absolutely, absolutely. We agreed it was appropriate that you should leave. But I didn't want your new community to think that we were letting you go because we were unhappy with you. We were letting you go because we no longer wanted you. I wanted them to understand it was with great reluctance that you were leaving here. We would love for you to stay. We value you. And I wanted them to make sure that they took that message with them." So he says, that is the Maggid of Dubna, says that's what's happening. The angels didn't genuinely want to keep the Torah. They understood the Torah was for human beings, was for us, was not for them. The Torah is to give us guidance and instruction and life and connection to Hashem and bracha and goodness and all of these things. But it's for us. But they didn't want us to take that for granted. They wanted us to know how precious it is, that they themselves would like to keep it. In fact, it's very interesting, this Gemara makes a point of telling us that Moshe had to answer them, that we have to justify for ourselves why we need, why we deserve the Torah. It's something so important and something so special. When you take it for granted, all of its impact is lost. It has to be something that we stop and think about what a privilege it is that we've been given this Torah, this wisdom from Hashem. Have a wonderful Shabbos.